Well, back now with breaking news. Boris Johnson is under more pressure to resign this morning after a damning report into boozy lockdown parties at Number 10 revealed a failure of leadership.
Nine's Europe correspondent Brett McLeod is following the developments in London. Brett, good morning to you. The British PM has apologised again.
Again, and sorry is becoming the easiest word now for Boris Johnson. He's had to use it so many times. But today was particularly important, though, because there's a report by civil servant Sue Gray, the first official inquiry we've seen into the allegations of parties at Downing Street during strict lockdown. She found there were failures of leadership and judgment by different parts of Number 10 and the Cabinet Office. Now, no names are named because of all the 18 parties, 18 she was investigating, 14 are still in the hands of police, and there may be charges to follow. Boris Johnson did probably the most sensible thing he could do. He went into Parliament as soon as these details came out to make his apology.
I want to say sorry. And I'm sorry for the things we simply didn't get right, and also sorry for the way that this matter has been handled.
So, Brett, I guess the big question is, can he hang on as Prime Minister or does he go?
There's a definite defiance in his voice after he delivered that apology, trying to get back onto the government's record on things like Ukraine, on vaccines and that sort of thing. But the wind was knocked out of his sails as he came under sustained critical attack, not just from the opposition, but from his own MPs, from Tory MPs, and one in particular, woman standing behind him who'd clearly been waiting to ask a very pointed question, the woman he replaced in Downing Street, Theresa May.
So either my right honourable friend had not read the rules, or didn't understand what they meant, and others around him, or they didn't think the rules applied to Number 10. Which was it?
After that, Boris started looking more and more deflated as the questions kept coming and the attacks kept coming. Now, he has been trying to reassure MPs that the government's going to turn a corner, but he is now still facing more resignations. Another government member has resigned tonight. It's expected in the next couple of days it'll be critical in finding out whether there'll be enough backbench MPs willing to tip out the man who many saw as the one who got them into government only 2 years ago.
He is under the pump. Brett, thank you.